So I'm just going to show you how we are going to create a supplier here. So first we have to create a supplier. After that we'll be creating supplier address, supplier site, site assignment, this. This is the page where we are going to create supplier, supplier general information, supplier address, supplier sites, nothing but branches, contacts and qualifications. So four steps are mandatory. Address we have to create. Supplier already we have done. Let me create the address here. Attribute person ID is required. This user is not a person. That's what it is showing error message. This user is an implementation user. He is not an employee user. That's why it is not allowing us to create the address. So let me log in with the person user. It's as simple as employee user. We already created supplier, right? So we can search, select supplier. We can see purchase agreements, purchase requisitions, purchase orders, negotiations. Negotiation is nothing but RFQs and quotations and receipts, and we can have procurement dashboard. So the functionality wise, 80% it will be same. It's not only in any ERP obviously, but the features are different. The setups are different, security is different, navigation is different, roles also different here. That's what we will find. So now go to addresses here. Let me create an address. I just entered an address here. This is for ordering purpose and as well as for RFQ and bidding. So like this, we have to create an address. Address is nothing but the client, supplier office, where exactly it is located. And we will be creating that supplier site for that address. So address is already created successfully. Then go for site. Then you can see that system will ask you the address name. It is mandatory. And the purpose of this site is for purchasing as well as for payment purpose also. And site assignment. So you must assign this particular site to the business unit. Business unit is nothing but a branch, like operating unit. In EBS, we used to call it as an operating units. Here we call it as a business unit. Then after that, we'll define the contacts. Okay, but contacts are optional, not mandate. Even if we want to load the suppliers, four levels are mandate. Supplier, supplier address, supplier sites, then supplier site assignment. So these are the four things. So this is how we can see the familiarity of the ERP product. This how. So for example, you would like to go for create an requisition. So go to purchase requisition. So now I can go for create a requisitions here. I can search existing requisitions here. Let me create a requisition. Directly it will ask us to enter the line, requisition line details, because it takes the header information automatically, like requisition number and all it takes automatically. That's a little bit slow. Now we can see what you would like to buy and requisition line information we are going to enter here. How much quantity is required? And what is the price, unit of measurement? Is negotiations are required? Source type is a supplier. You can suggest it's better to buy so and so supplier. And billing information is nothing but our distributions. We can see our key flux fields like distributions. So chart of accounts, ledger, the entire concept is similar. So we'll find the complete accounting combinations and all this. So click add to cart. So now click this cart. We can see the header information, line information, and distributions. All the informations over here. So you would like to review this requisition or you would like to submit? So I wanted to go for review this. Now we can see the requisition header information here. This is requisition number. This is our business unit, nothing but our operating unit, what we'll call description. This is all header information. Requisition amount, total amount, currency, this all, and any approval. And this is about requisition line information. Item name, item description, quantity, unit of measurement, this. And we can see the shipping details here, delivery and distributions. And you will see a lot of options like notes, attachments, and this all information. We can see that. And then we can check this output directly here in the PDF. Now this is our requisition report, which we can see directly in the PDF. And we can also manage the approvals. There will be AME, approval management engine. We will find different hierarchies. So we can go ahead with practicing here. It seems in the weekend everybody will be connected to the server. That's why it seems a little bit slow. But this is our demo instances. It's not commercial instance. But functionality wise, all the permissions you will see and all access you will see here. So that is we are able to find. But the fast and other options like application stability are a little bit different. Okay. So this is how we can go for create and transactions. So that's about the basic options. Now here is our syllabus. So if please drop your email ID and phone number, we will share you the syllabus copy here. We'll be talking about first FSM, Functional Setup Manager, how to create implementation project. This all will be simple, not much complex. Then we'll be discussing the security console, how to create our own user and adding the roles to the users. and overview of roles and customization of roles we'll be discussing. And we'll talk about the enterprise structure definition. Like in EBS, we used to have the multi-arc structure, right? Business group, ledger, legal entity, operating unit. After that, inventory organizations, and then sub-inventories, stock locations, and items. Of course, last will not come under multi-arc. It comes under within the inventory. Whereas in Fusion, we'll call it as an enterprise structure. We'll call it as enterprise structure. Here we'll see enterprise. Here we will find the enterprise here. And we will find divisions. After that, we'll find legislative data group. Then after that, we'll find ledger. Then legal entity. Then business unit. Then inventory. These are all common. This sub-inventories, these all are common. So additionally, what we will find here is, this is our multi-arc structure and this is our enterprise structure here in Fusion. This is in EBS and Fusion. You got enterprise and division additionally over here. So you got enterprise and division additionally over here it is. Then we got LDG, legislative data group, and this will be business group. Ledger common, same currency, calendar, chart of accounts, compliance method will be creating. Legal entities are common, legal organizations where the client has registered their business legally. And operating unit, we used to call it as in EBS, like sales office, procurement unit, payables, receivables, all financial transactions, wherever is happening, we used to call it as operating units. Whereas in Fusion, we are going to call it as a business unit. And inventories, sub-inventories, like that is common in Fusion, it is. So this is enterprise structure. It will be a little bit similarity, but we will see additional features provided by Oracle in the Fusion Cloud options. Okay, that's about an enterprise structure. So over here it is. Okay. So here we'll be talking about this entire enterprise structure. So what is enterprise? How to create divisions? Configuring the ledgers, legal entities, business unit. But actually, as a supply chain management consultant, our main work will start from here, from the business unit and inventory here. But even though we must learn how to define enterprise, how to define division, how to define ledger and legal entity, how to configure this entire enterprise structure, we must understand. Even our work is mainly here, but still the entire process, we should know it. So obviously we'll be discussing right from the beginning of this options. Okay. Fine. So this is about the differences of enterprise structures. So anybody is having doubts? So we talked about the future of the enterprise like ERP. What the expectation, cloud, mobility, social integrates and analytics. And we talked about different offerings in the Fusion Cloud ERP. What are offerings? And what we are going to learn, we have discussed. And different release versions. Now, latest version is release 30. The same version everybody has to use. All over the world, everybody has to use. Every year, there will be a changes in the product. That Oracle will do it. Every year, 3 times they will do it. January to April, first 4 months, next second 4 months, and third 4 months. Every 4 months, they'll go for provide the, not new versions, they'll provide the new features in the product and enterprise structures. And these are main modules we are going to talk. We'll be discussing inventory model, order management, and distributed order orchestration, DOO, and also we'll be talking about the pricing model and the procurement product information management. This is mainly used to configure the items, mainly inventory items we'll be doing. So here we don't do any inventory transactions like a sub-inventory transaction or miscellaneous transaction or this type of things, we don't do it here. So we'll be doing that in the inventory module. Here only set up the items, setting up the items, item catalogs, item categories, that setups we are going to do it here. And this is for the technical consultants. If somebody is very strong in the technical area and they wanted to know what are the alternatives provided by Oracle in the FISN compared to technology differences between the EBS and the FISN. Okay. So that's about the syllabus, what we have discussed here. So anybody is having any other doubts, please raise the hand and enter in the chat window. And yes, many people has given the phone number and email ID. Please drop, in case if you are not dropped your phone number and email ID, please drop it, we will share. Yes, there is a certification supply chain management. You can do it, SCM specialist ROM. And we are ready to support you to clear the supply chain management FISN certifications. Okay, fine. Yes, the batches will be started from next week. There are weekend batches. Starts morning 7 a.m. IST to 9:30 a.m. IST, both Saturday and Sunday. So it will be 5 hours per week. There will be a weekday batches. It will be morning 6 a.m. IST to 10 a.m. IST. So that timing will be 1 hour, 6 to 7 or 7 to 8 or 8 to 9. But that will, you have to discuss with the coordinator, training coordinator. So it will be Monday to Friday. So that also 5 hours. So even if you attend for weekend batch, the same syllabus will be covered. Even if you attend weekdays batch also, same. It will be covered. Yes. Okay. So if somebody want to learn the FISN technical also, this particular course is going to be suitable. So because we are going to cover complete technical, supply chain management, complete technical. Once I explain supply chain management technical part, you can easily adapt financial technical, HR technical. You don't find much difficult. Okay. If somebody says, I'm a pure functional consultant, I'm expecting end-to-end implementation of the product. Yes, this is the course and this is the area where you will get all these options. And we are providing the documentation. We have a soft copy and everything will be online. Through online, we are going to provide. Let me show you how we are going to give the access to the users. Let me open our syllabus of this copy. Here it is. So this is our company, RTL Online Trainings, and website. And this is our phone number. We are based out in Bangalore. And every session will be recorded and it will be shared through your Gmail. So right now, whatever the demo session today we have, this also it will be shared through your Gmail ID. So whatever the Gmail ID you have shared to us, through that we are going to share it. And there will be a WhatsApp group for the people who has enrolled for the course. And I'll be also the part of that particular group. Okay. So when you are practicing at home, you get any doubt, through WhatsApp group you can communicate with us. And I'll be giving you the reply. And after completion of this particular course, there will be a project explanation. Documentation will be seeing OEM methodology, Oracle Unified Methodology documents we are going to see, implementation methodology documents. And if somebody is looking for a placement or something, we'll be able to give the resume preparations and the interview preparations. and the cloud access will be given for 6 months. After 6 months, if you are expecting the server access, you need to pay monthly 1,000 rupees. It means around $13. $13 we have to pay per month to get the access from Oracle. Okay. So that's how we are going to do our training in the next level. So first we'll be starting with the functional part. So we'll be doing the functional. Then we'll be going for technical part. So we'll be talking about the inventory model. So inventory setups, creation of life cycle items, and inventory transactions like miscellaneous receipt and transactions movement, sub inventory transfers. This all we'll be doing, and serial control, lot control, revision control, how it will be done, replenishments like min-max planning all inventory. And we will be having the procurement. For procurement, we'll be talking about all our procurement setups, document setups like requisition, purchase order, RFQs, quotations, and lookups configuration. This all procurement buyers, this all we'll be discussing. Pay on receipt, buyer assignments, this everything we'll be discussing. We don't have concurrent programs in Fusion. Another name is there, ESS jobs. We call it as a ESS jobs. We'll be running that from here. Like SRS window we have in EBS. This we'll call it as a scheduled and process. Scheduled process. You are going to schedule your process here. One process is nothing but one program. Job is there, job set is there. In EBS, we used to have concurrent program and request set. We used to call as a request and request set. In EBS, we used to create executable, concurrent program, request group responsibility. There is a procedure to register the programs and reports. Here also, there is a procedure. We call it as ESS jobs. There is an option called, I don't have setups here. Once we build the BI reports and all, we are going to register here. Let me log out from this user because this user doesn't have the access to setups. There is a task here, select your, for example, you want to do it for procurement. You can go for an implementation project. There is only one step is required for implementation of this or registration of the reports. Manage custom enterprise jobs for HCM benefits. This is for compensation. This is for under. So you want to register your reports in financials. Finance implementation project. This is for financials applications. There will be only one task which we can directly open and register. Here we are going to register our, this all are built-in. The built-in programs registration, you can provide list of values and job sets. And you want to go for define new one, you can define. I'll be showing you all this, like only BI publisher I'm going to show you. If you have a platform as a service, it means if your client has subscribed to this, platform as a service or on-premises implementation. Then you can build your own SQL Plus scripts, SQL Loader, PLSQL, Java, Perl, Unix, C language. This all languages can be done. But right now we are working in the SaaS environment, right? This is what our course, SaaS environment. Functionally, no problem. Whether it is SaaS or PaaS or on-premises, doesn't matter technically. So I'll be explaining how we can build our reports, BI publisher reports, how to add the parameters, how to provide list of values. This all will be discussed. So from the technical point of view, it comes over here. Yes, any other doubts here? Yes, please subscribe to our YouTube channel so to get the latest videos about the latest features of the cloud and other things. And from next week onwards, the batches will be started, as I told. So please contact our coordinator on this number. They'll be able to adjust your this. And two, if you are looking for this recorded session, please drop your email ID and phone number. Thank you. Thank you very much for your valuable time. 2 hours you have spent with me. It was very nice. And let's see you going forward. We'll see in the next level. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Yes, regarding commercials, course fees and all, please contact the coordinator through that number. WhatsApp, you can discuss with training coordinator, because I'm not the right person to interact with that. I'm sorry. Please talk with them. Thank you. Yes, if you are looking for this particular demo session video, please drop your email ID, or even if you ping your phone number, we will share the WhatsApp group. Through that, you can access this recording session, can be accessed.